Hi, I'm Bob Welds, and this is how to read an architect scale. The type of architect scale we're going to look at is used to make measurements on a drawing that is dimensioned in feet and inches, like architectural drawings. You see, architectural drawings like house plans are drawn to a particular scale. In this case, a quarter inch on the drawing represents 1 foot in real life. The cabinets on the drawing are 12 feet 8 inches wide. If you measure the drawing of the cabinets with a regular ruler, you would see that they would be a little longer than 3 inches wide. To get an exact measurement, we would need to do some calculations. Here is an architect scale. When we use a scale like this, we don't need to do any calculations. Architect scales are designed to work with scaled drawings. On an architect scale, there are different marks for the foot and the inch parts of the measurement. On one side of this zero is where you measure the feet, and on the other side is where the inches come from. One of the keys to understanding a scale like this is to see that the part where you get the inches, the end with the small marks, is really just an ordinary 12-inch long ruler that has been shrunk down to the scale you're using. The hardest part is figuring out what each small mark means. First, we want to be sure we're using the right scale. You see that this scale is labeled 1/4. This means that you use this scale on drawings that are drawn to a scale of 1/4 inch equals a foot, like our cabinet drawing. Let's look at the inch part of the scale first. Now, remember that I said the inch part of the ruler is just an ordinary 12-inch long ruler that has been shrunk down to the scale you're using? Well, with this scale, it's easy to see that. Look closely and count the number of marks on this teeny tiny 12-inch ruler. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There, easy. Each mark represents 1 inch. Let's look at a different scale. Let's look at 1/8 of an inch equals a foot. Notice that this scale is at the other end of the ruler. On this scale, the inch part is on the left and the feet are on the right. Now remember that we said that the inch part of an architect scale is just a 12-inch long ruler that has been shrunk down to the scale you're using? Let's take a close look at the 12-inch ruler here and see what each mark means. Last time, we said that each mark represented 1 inch. Well, this scale is tinier than the last one, and it doesn't seem to have as many marks. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do you see that each mark on this scale represents 2 inches instead of just 1? Good! That's the hardest part of using this kind of scale. Figuring out what each mark on the inch part represents. Now, let's look at one more scale. Let's look at the scale for 3/4 of an inch equals a foot. First, we look for the zero, and we find here the inches are on the left and the feet are on the right. We'll remember that this part of the ruler represents a 12-inch long ruler that has been shrunk down to the scale we're using. Now, let's count the marks. 1, 2, 3. Wait a minute, there's too many to count. Let's do this a faster way. Since we know that this is a 12-inch long ruler that's been shrunk down, we know that halfway is 6 inches, and half of that is 3 inches. That would make this 1 inch, and the smallest mark is a half an inch. I think you understand the inch part of these scales. Let's move to the easy part. Let's look at the part of the scale that is used to measure whole feet. Now, remember how we said that the inch part of an architect's scale is a 12-inch ruler that's been shrunk down? I thought you did. Now, remember that 12 inches equals 1 foot. We'll look at the inch part of the ruler to see how big a foot would be at this scale. There. Now, let's flip that foot over and count. 1, 2, 3, 4. What's that? Oh, I see. Sparky said someone is asking about the extra marks and numbers. Those marks are counting whole feet from the other end of the scale. On this ruler, the 1/8 inch equals a foot scale is on the same part of the ruler as the 1/4 inch equals a foot. You just read them from different ends. See how this scale is counting in the other direction? 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. You can just ignore the extra marks coming from the other end of the ruler. So let's dive in and take some measurements. When we measure with an architect scale, we'll first measure the number of feet, then slide the ruler over and measure the inches. Here, I'll show you. We start by putting the item to be measured at the zero mark. Now, count the number of whole feet. 1, 2, 3. Good. Now, slide the ruler over to the last whole foot. Now, measure the inches. 1, 2, 3. So the measurement is 3 feet, 3 inches. Now, we're going to let you try a few. I'll position the reading at 0 and then slide the ruler over and let you measure the feet and the inches. When you see Sparky's paws, pause the video and write down your answer. First, here's one at the same 1/4 inch equals a foot scale. Hit the pause button and think about it. The reading is 2 feet 11 inches. Did you get that? Good, let's try a harder one. We'll try one at 1/8 inch equals a foot. Pause the video and take your time on this one. Did you say 5 feet 4 inches? If you did, you really know what you're doing. If not, let's have a look at what marks to count. See? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 feet. And each inch mark counts as 2 inches. The numbers 20 and 22 are from the other side of the ruler, so just ignore them. We'll do one more. If you get this one, you'll be ready for that test tomorrow. Okay, pause the video. The correct reading is 1 foot, 1 inch. Well, that's all the time we have for now. If you want more practice problems, or if I need to clear something else up, just let me know. I'm Bob Welds, and these are Weld Notes.